Hi everyone, in this tutorial, we will learn about behaviors. The behaviors will apply preset transformations or distortions to a clip to automatically create simple animations without keyframes. They can be found in the effects panel inside the behavior folder and applied as a regular effect. They have a dedicated section in the controls panel to adjust their settings. These animations generally have a start animation to reveal the clip. The duration of this animation can be adjusted with the reveal length slider, and its value represents the percentage of the clip's length. So if we trim the clip, the speed of this reveal animation will be faster. And if we extend it, the reveal will be slower. The reveal length slider only goes up to 50%, but we can adjust it even further by dragging from the numbers value on the right. Some behaviors also have an outgoing animation at the end of the clip, which can be adjusted with the conceal length slider. Let's see how each animation works. Up insert or down insert will move the clip vertically from outside of the frame to place it smoothly in its location. At the end, it will move it out of the frame in the same direction. Roll will move the clip constantly in one direction. There is a different behavior for each direction: up, down, left, and right. Up roll is commonly used on text layers for credits. Roll behaviors do not have adjustable settings, so the only way to adjust its speed is by changing the length of the clip. We can also combine two of these to make the clip move diagonally. Drop will make the clip appear bouncing from the top left. In this example, I applied it to a basketball. Expansion compresses the clip vertically, moves it from the side of the frame, and rescales it. Fade will animate the transparency of the clip. Fly in and fade out brings the clip from above, transforming its scale as intro, and scales it horizontally, making it transparent as outro. Fly in and fly out brings the clip from the corner as intro and takes it out from another as outro. Fly to zoom in will bring in the clip by spinning it and scaling it up. Stretch in and zoom in will bring the clip to the frame from the side, scaling it up. Twirl scales and rotates the clip from the center. Zoom will transform the scale of the clips. Zoom in will make the clip smaller, and zoom out will make it bigger. And motion tracking will follow the movement of the clip below. This one is a different kind of behavior, so it has a dedicated video linked in the description. Some behaviors can be combined. For example, if I want this object to enter the scene with a twirl and later leave with an expansion, I can apply both behaviors to the clip. In the twirl behavior, I'll add value to reveal length and set the conceal length to 0. On expansion, I'll do the opposite: 0 to reveal and some value to conceal length. In this next example, I have this logo where each element is a different clip on a different track. I can apply a behavior to each clip, adjust them. I can add a plane with a behavior to make it more dynamic. And then I have a basic logo reveal without any keyframes. Although the image still feels a little jerky, so I can toggle the motion blur box in each clip's properties to smooth the resulting animation. And here's what that looks like. So that was an overview on behaviors. To learn more about Filmora Pro, make sure to check out our other tutorials in the series. And remember, there's no limit to what you can make.